Budgeters and Savers, Chris Budgets here with my check-in for the week. I'm pretty much very much actually really late. So if you guys follow me on Instagram, you know that I had a family emergency last week. So I am about a week behind. I really took the time off to just spend time with my family, get our things in order and stuff like that, get our household together. So, but I am back now. I am definitely late for my check-in because I will be getting paid in a few days, in like 3 days. I normally do my check-in every other week and then my weekly or my bi-weekly cash stuffing every other week. So here we have our check-in. Now I do have my miscellaneous envelope. It's empty. There's nothing in there. It's downstairs. I'm not even gonna go grab it. But this is what I have. Not too much, really. So I have 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, $28. So just shy of 30. And what I'm probably gonna do with this is because we are out of course, we're out of milk and eggs and vegetables and fruit. So I'm probably gonna go pick up a few essentials tomorrow. I do go grocery shopping twice a week and I haven't gone all weekend. We've been pretty bad, honestly, since this whole family emergency happened. So we've been eating out, haven't been cooking at home as much. We've just been really flustered, just trying to catch up on sleep and everything like that. So that is where we are at. And I did want to show you guys, have my little coffee maker here. Let's see if I can put it. We have a problem though, because my daughter lost the K-cup, but you put your K-cup in here. Put your little cup down here. And it's so cute. It even makes a little noise. How cute is that? So I'm gonna go ahead and put our little toy to the side there and grab my binder real quick. So I do have my binder. And pretty much we have $30 left of our $200 grocery budget. Our miscellaneous and food envelope, all of that $100 is gone. We probably actually even went over. I know my husband spent some of his spending money. We've just been eating out. We've just been being bad. Everything just pretty much went out the window this past week. And then gas, I did get some gas and I spent $16, so I do have extra $3 and some change in my checking account. So of course, as you guys know, I say it again and again, the two challenges that I'm participating in throughout the year, I'm doing the 1 in 5 challenge and the zero out challenge. So 1 in 5s, you know, you save all of your 1 in 5s throughout the year, you count it up, you put it towards your sinking funds or your debt or whatever the goal is for that. And then the zero out challenge, I basically just transfer any money that I have left over. If I have any bills or anything like that and the total due was actually less than what I had budgeted for, what I had anticipated, I will transfer that money over to my savings. Sometimes it's nothing and sometimes it's something. It really just depends. It could be as small as, you know, just a few dollars. Or the last time I did it, I actually had a few refund checks, like small, like insurance reimbursement checks for like $23, $20 here, but it totaled up to like 70 something. So I was able to transfer that to my savings. So that is all that I have really for this check-in. It's not much going on here, you guys. I'm just catching up, but I did want to go ahead and touch base on my April savings challenges. So that is what I'm really excited for. So even though I haven't been on social media, I still have been outside looking out the window and getting my life together so I can, you know, see if it's gonna rain or not. Now, the two challenges I am participating in are the Make It Rain challenge and of course the April Showers Savings challenge. And I have been keeping up, or trying to keep up. 5, 10, 15, 20, and then bonus week or week 5 is $25. So I have been keeping up with this challenge. There's really not a whole lot to it. You can make it fun and add different numbers, add a 5, add an extra $5 for the week, whatever you can do. But this is the most I'm going to be able to commit to. This is a little bit more concrete numbers, so there's no guessing, which I appreciate for this month because, of course, I'm doing the April shower savings challenge, which we all know the weather. So with that being said, I actually was watching, I think Brie Budgets, Brie Life Budgets. If you guys follow her, she is a new mom. She has an Etsy shop. I follow her on Instagram and YouTube. I'll link her down below. And she was saying that it rained like so many times this week. And honestly, I don't even know. We are actually in the same state. So I was like, oh, let me look up and make sure I'm, you know, been keeping on track. But this is what I have. If I am wrong, if you guys live near me, y'all let me know what days it rained, because last week was, this whole probably like week and a half has been such a blur. So I've been trying to keep up, trying to remember. I know for sure it rained yesterday. So today is Sunday the 25th. I know for sure it rained on the 24th, and I don't really remember anything else. But so far I have 8 days of rain, and I am doing it for $5 per day. Now, I was going to do like $2.50 adult, you know what I mean? But I have committed to the $5 a day. So right now we're at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 8 days. 8 times 5 is 40. Is that right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40. So we're at $40 so far, and we still have about another week left. So we're gonna have to see, because I did check the weather for next week. Let me check on my phone right now, actually. Let's see. Okay, so I did check the weather. I'm just gonna cover the, check the weather, and it looks, here we go. So I have 63, 81. I have one more day, one more rainy day, it looks like next Friday. So we will have to see if it actually rains or not. But I'm in the state of Virginia, so we will see. We will, I'm trying to decide. This is most likely gonna go, this is most likely gonna go towards a credit card payment, and also this one is probably gonna go towards a credit card payment also, because I'm trying to get rid of debt. Because of our family emergency, it definitely put us back some. But you know, what can you do when life happens? There's only so much that you can do, but I just wanted to say that we are home, everyone's home, everything's okay. We're managing all of the pain and everything like that at home. So, you know, not to worry. I just didn't feel like I could be present on social media at that time. It's just so much going on, and just, yeah, it was just so much. So yeah, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you guys in my next video. Okay, here we go.